can.
Let my people go. So.
Only when I came to Israel, then I first heard it told that Elijah will come again someday. I have seen him, he is real, and I just can't help but feel how much closer his kingdom is today. Signs of the times are everywhere, oh, and we in Israel can say without fear, keep your eyes upon Elijah King. Obey his voice, the kingdom now is near. Wars and strifes on every hand, and violence fills our land. Still some people doubt that he's not the one, but the word of God is true. He redeemed his chosen few. Don't lose hope, Elijah will see us through. Without fear, keep your eyes upon Elijah your King. Obey his voice, the kingdom now is here.
Shalom. Which simply means peace be unto you. This is another edition of the House of Israel Bible class, and we're here to study the words of God. Time and time again, we want to say to the folks that watch our programs on YouTube, on Facebook, all the way up in New Amsterdam, all the way up in the quarantine, we're thankful that you can take time out from your busy schedule to watch the program and learn a little more on the subject of Elijah. We're happy to bring this message to you. And it's always a privilege, and it brings joy to our hearts and our minds and our soul to able to teach you and to give you some of the true sayings of Jesus. We know today that the world is what we call Jesus nice. That everybody is concerned with what Jesus said. But we want to bring some more light to you to teach you that Jesus had a purpose on earth. And all the while he was here, his purpose was to bring people to God. To let people understand that there is a greater than Jesus. He would often, whenever he do something, give all the praises, the honor, the glory unto Elijah. And you know, sometimes when we say Elijah, people ask, who is this Elijah? That's our subject today. after Jesus in his every move. Was establishing the greater power. For his disciples, he was teaching them how to get this eternal life. And he wasn't saying to get it, you must know me. But he was saying to get it, we must know Elijah. You know, I want to say this because many of the my Christian friends and brothers, they sincerely want to get this eternal life. And they have been in these churches. Seeking it. Oh, but when one don't work out, they go to another. And what we have? We have years of wasted time in religions that Jesus know nothing about. And we want to read what Jesus said. Jesus telling us how to get it. How we gonna receive it is knowing Elijah. Listen what he said in the book of St. John 17 and verses 3. St. John 17 and verses 3. Listen to what Jesus said. He said, and this is life eternal. Holy said, this is not only life, but life eternal. This is how you will live forever. I tell you, this is sweet, you know. Living a world where there is no death. But to have it, listen to what he says. And this is life eternal, that they might know thee, that all Jesus would teach us. To know the only true God. That's the reason why Jesus says, search the scriptures. He said in them, you think you have life. This life is to know God. And I'm saying, I know a lot of folks is sincere. But in your sincerity, search for this one true God. Listen what it says again. I want you to listen. He said, and this is life eternal. That is entire earth. you know, if Jesus had said, this is life eternal, that we may know Jesus Christ, the entire heart would be right. But he didn't say that. He said, this is life eternal. Oh, that they might know thee. Oh, that we may know Elijah. We might serve him. You know why Jesus was teaching so? Because he said the things concerning him. Oh, this is sweet. Jesus said, the things concerning me, he said, they got an end. Oh, they must come to an end. I tell you, this is sweet. Let us follow what he said. This is life. Oh, not only life. Eternal life. That we, in our quest for God, would know Elijah. He said, and Jesus Christ, whom thou hast sent. Study it. I tell you, this word is sweet. Sweet, let's listen. Because you see, all of the folks have placed all their emphasis on Jesus. How about that's not what the word said? Every time he spoke, he said, I'm glorifying you, Elijah. I'm making known your name. Listen what he said. Listen. He said, I have glorified thee on the earth. I have finished the work which thou givest me to do. I tell you, Jesus here is a servant. He's working for somebody. I mean, if God give me some work to do, and I'm telling him, he said, look, I finished the work you give me to do. The only reason I can speak like that, because I'm a servant. Yes. That's verse 4, the same St. John 17 and 4. Listen. Oh, I wish that we would read the whole 17th chapter of John. Listen to what he said in verse 6. Listen. He said, I have manifested thy name. Oh, not the name of Jesus. Manifest, it means to make known. That's my purpose for being here. Oh, is that I tell the world about you, Elijah. You see, If you don't have your Bible and your pens with you, jot the scriptures down. Study them. Oh, we wish that you would study them. Because you see, our pastors and our deacons, they got us all mixed up. Mixed up in our effort to find God. I got a pastor and he keep talking to me about some tree God somewhere. Verse 3, Jesus said, the one God. Verse 6, listen what he said. He said, I have manifested thy name. Jesus didn't come to bring a message about himself, but all his effort is to establish Elijah. He said, I have manifested thy name. Make it known. Tell you, we love Jesus. We love Jesus because Jesus said, I am not sent but unto the lordship of the house of Israel. He said, this is my religion. Yes. We want to read a little more. Because in our search, we want to be able to put line upon line, precepts upon precepts, here a little, there a little. We want to really understand this thing. What God is telling us through the mouth of Jesus. Listen, verse 11. Listen, you see, this is for all the folks that still want to worship Jesus. Listen to what it says. He said, and now I am no more in the world. I love when Jesus speak. Jesus. St. John 17 and 11. Listen to what he said. He said, I am no more in the world. But he said, these are in the world. Talking about you and I. But we are in the world. You got to stay with me. Stay with me. Study with us. Listen to what he's telling the Father. He said, and I come to thee, Holy Father. You know, Jesus had to die, go on the cross, and then go to heaven. He said, I'm coming to you, Holy Father. But I'm begging you. He said, I'm asking you. Oh, listen what I'm asking you. Oh, that you keep them. In your name. You know, I want to say this, you know, because many people might not understand it, but it's true. At no time the church was to be kept in Jesus' name. Hear what Jesus is saying. He said, look, I am coming to you, Holy Father. Means he understands that it's his time to die. He said, wish that you would hear what we're saying. Kill them in your name. I'm telling you that this is what must be preached. Jesus is giving us all the directions. That if we're going to be kept, we got to be kept in Elijah's name. Yes, I want to read some more. I tell you, this is really sweet. Real sweet. We want to go in the book of Ephesians. Ephesians 3. Because you know, once we hear, we ought to lead these people to God. We ought to give them the best directions. And this is how Paul put it in the book of Ephesians 3. And verse 14, because you see, when you're getting ready to bow your knees, you're getting ready to give praise and thanks, you must know who you're giving it to. Listen to what he said. He said, for this cause, I bow my knees. I'm ready to give reverence. I'm ready to give glory, honor. Listen. He said, for this cause, I bow my knees unto the Father. Oh, we wish that you would hear what we're saying. Not to Jesus. I want to read it again. For the folks maybe that just came in and is now having a chance to look at the program, listen to what it says. This is Ephesians 3, verse 14 and 15. He said, for this cause, I bow my knees. I will give praise to the highest. He said, unto the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. And you know, we got folks all over the place talking about Jesus, this Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. He said to the Father of Jesus Christ. Listen. He said, of whom the whole family. Oh, this man is responsible. For Jesus, Moses, John. I tell you, Elijah is the name. We just want to read one more just before we close. Because this is the closing of the Old Testament. And while we was fixing to get to the new, where everybody would be talking more and more about Elijah, Malachi said something. Listen to what he said in the book of Malachi. Malachi 4, I tell you, this is a sweet scripture. And what I'm praying is that we were able to understand it. Because it's our last chance. I tell you, it's our last chance, you know. You know, now let me say this. All the prophets, we kill them. And God made a decision. That I'm going to send Elijah. I tell you, it's our final chance. We got to decide what we're going to do. We're going to decide if we go do him like Jesus or accept him. But nevertheless, listen to what it is said here. Malachi 4, verse 5 and 6. Listen to what it says. It says, behold, he said, I will send you Elijah the prophet. You know, if God wanted us to be in a guessing game, because I'm going to tell you why I said this. Every religion except the house of Israel, they're guessing who's coming. You know, some people say it's Allah is going to return. Some say it's Ram and Sita, they're going to return. Some say it's Jesus, the phony one. But God makes it clear. He said, I'm going to send you Elijah, the prophet. Look at when he's coming. Before the great and the dreadful day of the Lord. When there is no hope. I tell you, people have lost hope. But if we could just agree with God, that this one that comes, we're going to accept him. Listen what Elijah is going to do. Listen. I tell you, Elijah has the greatest work. You think it is easy to restore this entire earth? Listen what he said. He said, and he shall turn, change things. You look at the world today. Satan looks like if he's in control. That even the people that's evil. And you know what? Elijah has to change that. So he gonna turn. Turn means to change. Put us back where we were. God got to do something that man has never seen. Said he gonna turn the hearts of the fathers to the children. Now, you tell me this. God, Elijah, is going to give me a heart like Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. That all my focus could be on Elijah. You study Abraham. All his mind was on God.
God tell him, he said, look, I want to see how much you love me. He said, take your son, your only son. He said, go and sacrifice him unto me. Oh, that's real love. Abraham got the little boy, put him on the horse, and gone with the knife to sacrifice him unto God. But look at the work of Elijah. Listen what he said, I'm going to do. I'm going to turn this heart, this mind that you got. Give you one like Abraham. Where I can get your attention. But listen. You can decide who is Elijah. But he said, if I fail, he said, I'm going to smite the earth with a curse. You see, the reason I'm leaving this with you, that you can think. Because you see, when John failed, Jesus was coming. But when Jesus failed, and I tell you, he failed. You know what Jesus said? He said, I go to my Father and you see me no more. You know why? Because you believe not on me. He said, but if we refuse Elijah, he said, I will smite the earth with a curse. The ball is in our court. We can do what we want with it. But I'm urging you, let us accept the Lord Elijah. This is what I want to leave with you. This time, until the next time, may the Lord Elijah bless and keep you. This is my prayer.